If you've ever wondered what scientists can learn about planets outside our solar system, this video is for you. My name is Laura Kreidberg, and I'm a grad student in the Astrophysics Department at the University of Chicago, and I spend most of my time studying the atmospheres of exoplanets, which are planets orbiting stars other than the Sun. It turns out that the Milky Way is filled with exoplanets. We've barely searched even a tiny fraction of all the stars, and we've already found 1,000 confirmed planets as of October 2013. And some of these planets are even close enough to us that we can start studying their atmospheres to learn more about them, what they're made out of, what the conditions are on their surfaces, even whether they might be hospitable for life. And that's what I've been working on. I've been studying one planet in particular called GJ1214b. This planet is what's known as a super-Earth. That's a technical term for planets bigger than the Earth and smaller than Neptune. And I have some really exciting results about it that I want to share.
GJ1214b is an awesome planet to study because it's practically in our own backyard. It's about 40 light years away from us, which means that if you scaled down the Milky Way to the size of the United States, the planet would only be about a mile from Earth. Realistically speaking, it's still too far away to actually go there, but it's close enough for us to be able to learn a lot about it.
We already know that GJ1214b is really different from the planets in our solar system. It's about 3 times the radius of Earth, so in between Earth and Neptune in size. And even though our solar system doesn't have any planets in that intermediate size range, super-Earths like 1214b are one of the most common kinds of planets in the galaxy. Because these super-Earths are so abundant, astronomers would like to know whether these planets are truly scaled-up versions of the Earth, or instead something more like a miniature Neptune. This difference would have big implications for whether life could exist on these planets. We're sure, though, that life as we know it couldn't survive on GJ1214b. And that's because it orbits its host star really close in. It only takes about a day and a half, roughly 38 hours, for the planet to go all the way around the star. Because it's so close, the planet is really hot. Could be hotter than 400 degrees Fahrenheit, which is a higher temperature than the most extreme life forms on Earth can tolerate. We can learn a lot more about the planet by studying its atmosphere. GJ1214b is what's known as a transiting planet. It's lined up just right so that it passes between us and its host star every time it orbits. This is a fortunate situation for astronomers because we can use the star as a backlight to study the planet's atmosphere. When the planet is transiting, a small percentage of the starlight filters through the planetary atmosphere on its way to Earth, and information about the molecules that are present there is imprinted on the light that's passing through. Here's an example of what we would observe for an atmosphere made out of water vapor. Molecules can absorb light, and the amount of light that's absorbed depends on both what kind of molecule we're talking about and the wavelength or color of light. By measuring very precisely for each wavelength how much starlight is being blocked by molecules in the planet's atmosphere, we can work backwards to learn what the atmosphere is made out of. A team of collaborators and I used the Hubble Space Telescope to observe GJ1214b with this technique. We used a record amount of Hubble time for observing a single exoplanet, and this allowed us to make the first measurement ever that is precise enough to detect an Earth-like atmospheric composition on a planet outside the solar system. But what we found is very different from the Earth. We searched the spectrum for signs of water, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, methane, all the common molecules that we would expect to see in an atmosphere the temperature of GJ1214b. But we didn't see any of those molecules, and what that means is that there must be clouds in the atmosphere blocking our view. These clouds are not going to be like the clouds on Earth. GJ1214b is too hot for water to condense in the upper atmosphere, but it's possible for other kinds of clouds to form. For example, in our own solar system, we see clouds made out of sulfuric acid on Venus and ammonia on Jupiter. We think the clouds on GJ1214b could be made out of something even more exotic, potentially potassium chloride or zinc sulfide. GJ1214b has yet to reveal all of its secrets, but there are some new telescopes being built that should help us get to the bottom of this. One is the successor to Hubble, called the James Webb Space Telescope, which is scheduled for launch by NASA within the next 5 years or so. And there are also some huge ground-based telescopes being built. And not only will these telescopes help us solve the mystery of GJ1214b, but they'll also open the door to studying the atmospheres of smaller, cooler exoplanets more like our own Earth. And who knows what we'll find out there. So stay tuned.